right? Protozoans. Protozoans are, so they are that primitive relatives of animals. It is a objective bit. Primitive relatives of animals. Primitive relatives of animals are known as that protozoans, right? So these protozoans, so we observe that they are the primitive relatives of animals, right? So generally protozoans are parasites saprophytes and cell wall is absent heterotrophic condition heterotrophic condition right so these are the primitive relatives of animals it is the objective bit right so they are that parasites saprophytes and cell wall is absent and heterotrophic condition so these protozoans are divided into four groups so what are that amoeboid protozoans flagellated protozoans after then ciliated protozoans ciliated protozoans ciliated protozoans after then sporozoans okay they are that sporozoids right protozoans are primitive relatives of animals they are the parasites and cell wall is absent they causes diseases and saprophytes and heterotrophic condition protozoans are divided into four groups amoeboid protozoans flagellated protozoans ciliated protozoans after then sporozoans first what is that so amoeboid protozoans are generally they are that okay fresh water amoeboid protozoans amoeboid protozoans are so generally fresh water okay and after that so they are also involved it means they are that producing of the pseudopodia by the presence of pseudopodia they are used in the locomotion and catch their food from that organisms okay so pseudopodia so it is used for that capture of the food capture of food from organisms right and some are marine which one is that marine amoeba so they having that silica layer it is important it is known as that silica it is made up of silica okay marine so after then some amoeboid protozoans are parasites this parasitic amoeboid is known as that entamoeba 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 okay so it is causes diseases that is known as that amoebic dysentery amoebic dysentery right so these are that amoeboid protozoans after that flagellated protozoans flagellated protozoans are so this flagellated protozoans are act as that parasites flagellator protozoans. Okay, causes, act as the parasites. They cause diseases. It is known as sleeping sickness disease. Sleeping sickness disease is caused by Trypanosoma gambiens. Trypanosoma gambiens. So generally it is not observed in that, okay? So in India, generally it is that in African countries, so it causes diseases, okay? Sleeping sickness disease by the Trypanosoma gambiens, right? So that is known as that flagellated protozoans. After that flagellated protozoans, ciliated protozoans. Ciliated protozoans. So in the ciliated protozoans, what are that example is that paramecium. So in the paramecium, it is a paramecium. So in the surface is covered by that it is that paramecium. The surface is covered by thousands of cilia. They are used for locomotion purpose. So paramecium move, okay? So by that the coordinations of the thousands of cilia, so that is known as coordination moment. By the coordination moment, so then paramecium move from one place to the another place, and this paramecium absorbing water, so and also food material, so laden inside into that gullet. It is known as a gullet or reservoir. By the thousands of cilia are present on the surface of paramecium, by the coordination movement of cilia, so then water plus and food material is laden into that gullet are exerted, okay? So it is observed in that ciliated protozoans. This ciliated protozoan is known as that paramecium, okay? So that is known as ciliated protozoans. After this ciliated protozoans, sporozoans. After that sporozoans, they are also known as sporozoids, right? So it is infectious spore like structures. They are infectious spore like structures. Infectious spores are known as the sporozoans. For example, Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax cause malaria disease. In their life cycle, okay, these spores are known as that sporozoids. They are the notorious sporozoids. Notorious spore-like structures, spores, okay? They are that staggering effect on human population. It is known as that staggering effect.
by the decreasing of that human population. So they are completely known as that protozoans, right? After that protozoans, what is that next one? Fungi.
Fungi. So fungi are grown in everywhere. They are that unique plant kingdom. Unique plant kingdom. So they are that unique organisms. They are grown in everywhere. It means it is known as cosmopolitan. Cosmopolitan distribution. It means they are grown in everywhere. For example, spoilage of food. Orange rot. Okay, so next one, white rust, on mustard leaves, okay, they cause diseases, smuts, and also rust, okay, they are also act as that mostly, they are the saprophytic condition. They are the saprophytes. Okay. So where that food material, where that organic material is available, at that place, so fungi is grown easily. Okay, depend upon that source of organic material. So fungi are grown in that everywhere. Right? So after that, for example, in that fungi, it causes diseases, orange rot. Next one is spoilage of food and bread. Okay, so next one, white rust on mustard leaves, smuts, so and rust. So generally they are that saprophytes. Okay, after that, fungi causes diseases in some plants. Okay. Mostly it is a saprophytic condition. So it is that morphological simple and behavior is that also complex. Morphological and behavior is also complex in that fungi. Okay. For example, we are stored food material in refrigerator by the protection from the spoilage of food from that fungi. It means, so we stores food. In refrigerator. Because, so protect from fungi. Okay, so that is that fungi. So fungi are grown in, so what are the favorable places for growing, okay, fungi? So what are the good habitats, what are that favorable habitats or favorable conditions for growth fungi. For growth fungi, it means warm and humid places. Warm and humid places are favorable, okay, conditions for growth of that fungi. Next, for example, all fungi are okay multicellular condition. They are the multicellular generally, but except yeast. So yeast is that unicellular. Yeast is a unicellular, right? So yeast is used for that preparation of bread and also beverages. That's why, example, Saccharomyces. Okay, this Saccharomyces used for that preparation of bread. And beer, it means an alcoholic, that's why it is also known as the baker's yeast. Baker's yeast, preparation of bread, so that's why it is known as that baker's yeast, okay, and the preparation of bread and alcoholic, okay, so fermentation process, so that is known as that okay unicellular okay fungi, that is known as that yeast. After that, so antibiotics are also produced from that fungi. So it means penicillin antibiotic produced from fungi, that is known as penicillium notatum, right? So that is known as that, it means importance of the fungi. It is used as that antibiotic and production of the fungi penicillium notatum and preparation of bread and beer, okay? So this all are included in that fungi, right? After that, fungi are generally so that multicellular tube-like structures, multicellular and slender continuous tube-like structures. So multicellular, slender, continuous tube-like structures known as that hyphae. Okay, so this hyphae, it means just like that, it is a slender tubular like structures, branched or unbranched, okay? So they are known as hyphae. Network of hyphae, network of hyphae is known as that mycelium, right? So some filaments are hyphae are branched, some are unbranched, okay? Next, in some fungi, so they are known as that multinucleate condition, without formation of septa, so they are that multinucleate condition. Aseptate multinucleate condition observed in some fungi, generally it is in that rhizopus, that is known as cenocytic condition. It is that objective bit. Aseptate means, for example, so it is that filament, it having that number of nucleus but without cross walls are absent. Right, these are the cross walls, so these cross walls are absent, So that is known as aseptate. Aseptate multinucleate condition is known as that cenocytic condition. It is observed in rhizopus. So that generally it is commonly known as bread mold. Right. Next, cell wall is made up of chitin or polysaccharide substance. Chitin. Cell wall is made up of chitin substance. It is that homopolysaccharide. Homopolysaccharide. So it is that chitin. It is also known as fungal cellulose. It is also known as a fungal cellulose. So it is that object to beat. Fungal cellulose. So it is that homopolysaccharide. Okay, complex homopolysaccharide, that is known as that chitin. So storage of food material. In the storage of food material is glycogen or oil drops. Storage of food material in the form of glycogen or oil drops. They are that storage of food material in fungi. Okay, so these are that some. Okay, so cell structure about that fungi. After that, reproduction process. Fungi reproduction. Generally, vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation. Okay, in most of the fungi are multicellular, vegetative reproduction takes place by the fragmentation. But in yeast, vegetative reproduction is takes place by budding. It is at a unicellular. It is a unicellular condition. Right. After that, asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction takes place by that formation of spores. So, formation of spores. So, this formation of spores generally, it means non-motile spores. So they are known as that aplanospores. So these aplanospores are non-motile spores. Okay. So what are that? For example, sporangiospores,